But I'm funny how? I mean, funny like I'm a clown, I amuse you, I make you laugh.
One of the most recognizable faces in mobster movies is that of Joe Pesci. The Italian-American actor has made good use of his brash New Jersey smarts to fit the role of Italian criminals and clumsy burglars alike. His role as Harry in the Home Alone films also gained him recognition with younger crowds, and we can't ignore his short yet captivating musical career. In today's list, we will be looking at the top 10 Joe Pesci movies of all time.
Sheriff Farley, just to refresh the court's memory, what caliber bullet was used to murder Jimmy Willis?
Number 10, Lethal Weapon 3. Beginning our list is the third entry in the classic Lethal Weapon series of buddy cop action films. Released in 1992, Joe Pesci reprises his role as the obnoxious yet lovable Leo Getz, who has become a close friend to officers Riggs and Murtaugh. In fact, this is the first Lethal Weapon film where an actor other than Mel Gibson and Danny Glover gets top billing in the movie's poster.
I know the guy.
Leo, how do you know him?
I've seen the guy before.
You've seen him before?
I don't know. I mean, I recognize him from someplace.
His name's Jack Travis. Yeah.
A week before Murtaugh retires from the LAPD, he and his trigger-happy partner, Riggs, are called to action once again. This time, the duo has to stop an ex-LAPD officer who uses his knowledge of the police to sell illegal weapons. To portray the sleazy Leo Getz, Pesci had to tap into his con man persona, a character the actor has played many times throughout his career. However, for Lethal Weapon 3, he went one step above and dyed his hair platinum blonde. This gives Getz a slightly more crooked look than in other Lethal Weapon flicks.
Okay.
Taking a bath, Leo.
I could see that. And it's cold water, too. There goes your image.
Number 9, With Honors. Speaking of unsavory characters, With Honors is a film about a young college student whose future is held hostage by a homeless man, played by Pesci. The man keeps the thesis papers of Monty, a college student who is about to graduate and only plans to hand them over one page at a time if the young man obeys his outrageous demands.
No, sir. My presence here is the logical result of the search for edible garbage.
You're here for the garbage.
This dramedy stars Joe Pesci alongside Brendan Fraser, featuring an undeniable chemistry between the actors that is the highlight of the show. Even though the movie reached the top spot in the U.S. box office, critics were not pleased with the film's cliched plot. As a random piece of trivia, Claudia Haro, Joe Pesci's wife at the time, has a small cameo in the movie. Pesci was deeply involved with the production of the film, even deciding which actors could join the movie's cast.
Will you stop singing? Sing a song every day. Keep your voices high and gay. If everybody sings a song, never will the world go wrong.
Number 8, Home Alone 2, Lost in New York. After the surprise box office success that was the first Home Alone movie, a sequel was a no-brainer for 20th Century Fox. Home Alone 2, Lost in New York, takes the original formula of its prequel and expands upon it in bigger, louder, and more hilarious ways. This time, young Kevin McAllister boards the wrong plane, and instead of going to Miami to spend the holidays with his family, he ends up in the capital of the world.
Hotels. Tourists carry lots of cash.
There's no guarantees. I got a better idea.
To make matters worse, the duo of scatterbrained thieves that tried to rob his house last year are back, and they want their revenge. Pesci reprises the role of Harry, the smartest of the two burglars. Alongside actor Daniel Stern, Pesci had to do some of the film's stunts without using a double, particularly in one scene where a flock of pigeons surrounds them. He also established a friendship with young actor Macaulay Culkin, who was, at the time, the highest paid child actor in history.
Hiya, pal.
Number 7, Lethal Weapon 2. This movie marks the first appearance of Pesci and his character, Leo Getz, in the action franchise. In the sequel to the 1987 original, officers Martin Riggs and Roger Murtaugh return to action, this time to protect an annoying federal witness.
Yeah.
Whatever for?
Well, you see, this is such a bad time for him to go to South Africa. I mean, with all the trouble and everything, okay?
At the same time, Riggs and Murtaugh investigate a group of South African diplomats in Los Angeles who might be using their influences to connect with the city's criminal underworld. The movie's first draft had Joe Pesci's character in a much smaller role. That said, Pesci infused his personality into the role, changing Leo Getz's involvement in the plot completely. His character in Home Alone even pays homage to some of the most popular lines of Leo Getz.
Hey, no cars are coming.
Number 6, My Cousin Vinny. By 1992, Joe Pesci was already known for usually playing characters that were stereotypes of the brash Italian-American New Yorker. He would use that reputation to his favor in the comedy film My Cousin Vinny, a 1992 comedy that also featured Ralph Macchio and Marissa Tomei. The movie follows two young New Yorkers as they travel through Alabama. For seemingly no reason, the couple is arrested and put on trial for a murder they didn't commit. Vincent LaGuardia Gambini, aka Vinny, a lawyer who just barely made it out of the bar exam, takes their case.
Two different men drive up in a similar-looking car, go in, shoot the clerk, rob him, and then leave?
A clash between New York-style self-assertiveness versus Southern hospitality, with the young New Yorker's life on the line, and only Cousin Vinny there to save them, ensues. The movie was a commercial and critics' success. In 1998, Joe Pesci would release Vincent LaGuardia Gambini Sings Just For You, his second studio album. Pesci was a lounge singer before becoming an actor, and so far, the actor has released three albums.
I got a judge that's just aching to throw me in jail. An idiot who wants to fight me for $200.
Number 5, Home Alone. Chris Columbus's film about a kid who's left behind by his absent-minded family has become a landmark of the holiday season. Home Alone turned Macaulay Culkin into the biggest child star of the 90s and also holds the distinction of being the highest-grossing comedy film until 2011's The Hangover Part 2. The holidays are a hectic time for every family, and that goes double for the McAllisters. The family gets everything ready for a Paris vacation, everything but their youngest son, Kevin.
Merry Christmas, little fella. We know that you're in there and that you're all alone.
Left alone in his big house, Kevin will have to learn to fend for himself when a duo of burglars targets his home as their latest objective. Pesci took a liking to his young co-star and tried to stay in character during most of Home Alone's filming. He acted distant to Macaulay to make him think that he was as mean as his character in real life, although nothing is farther from the truth.
Hey, look, that house is the only reason we started working this block in the first place. Ever since I laid eyes on that house, I wanted it.
Number 4, The Irishman. The most recent entry into our list belongs to 2019's The Irishman, Martin Scorsese's modern tribute to a bygone era of crime cinema. Filmed making extensive use of digital de-aging techniques, this movie is a must-see for any fans of the crime films of the 70s that Scorsese himself is famous for.
Things have gotten out of hand with our friend again. And some people are having serious problems with him.
The Irishman chronicles the story of Frank Sheeran, a truck driver who becomes involved with the Italian mafia. His first contact with the mob is through Russell Bufalino and his crime family. Eventually, Sheeran would establish an enduring alliance with the infamous Jimmy Hoffa. Pesci plays the role of Russell Bufalino, the man responsible for guiding Sheeran through the complicated criminal network of the Italian mob. It wasn't easy for Scorsese and his team to convince Pesci to come out of retirement. Some sources say that the actor declined the role nearly 50 times before he ultimately agreed to join the project.
Jimmy was a good man, you know? A nice family too, huh?
Number 3, Raging Bull. If it seems like Joe Pesci and Robert De Niro had good chemistry in The Irishman, it might be because the duo has co-starred in 7 different films, including 1980's Raging Bull. In a time when the Rocky films were filling cinemas with feel-good stories of good sportsmanship and perseverance, Raging Bull offered a finely crafted drama about the life of an irate boxer and his fights in and outside the ring.
Hey, I'm your brother. You're supposed to believe me. Don't you trust me?
No, I don't.
Oh, you don't? That's nice.
I don't trust you when it comes to her.
This biopic tells the story of Jake LaMotta, a boxer characterized for his short temper and self-destructive tendencies. Along the way, LaMotta's only support came from his brother and manager, Joey. Robert De Niro stars as the complicated Jake LaMotta, with Joe Pesci acting as Joey. De Niro and Pesci lived and trained together for a time before filming began to make their brotherly relationship feel more genuine. That didn't stop De Niro from accidentally breaking one of Pesci's ribs in a scene that is still present in the movie's final cut.
Jack respects you. I mean, he don't even say hello to anybody. You know, he talks to, he likes you.
Number 2, Casino. The 8th film collaboration between Martin Scorsese and Robert De Niro is an all-star reunion of actors, including Sharon Stone, James Woods, and, of course, Joe Pesci. Like many great mobster films, Casino offers a cautionary tale about how power, corruption, and greed can destroy the lives of people.
You know, I think you should try to make the best of it now. Go slow, you know, see what happens.
He could have killed him. okay? He could have killed him.
Sam Rothstein, a.k.a. Ace, an expert gambler handicapper who also works as a casino executive, meets Nicky Santoro, a mafia initiate. The two men soon compete over control of a gambling empire and the love of the beautiful Ginger McKenna. Based on the real-life feud between Frank Rosenthal and Anthony Spilotro, Casino was met with overwhelmingly positive critiques. Making use of the solid chemistry between De Niro and Pesci, Scorsese let the two actors improvise most of their lines.
You know I'm trying to put something really big together out here. You know what I'm talking about, huh? You know. If you're acting like this now, how can I depend on you?
Our number one pick is Goodfellas. Among crime movie fans, there's a common dilemma. Which one is better, Goodfellas or The Godfather? Both movies are considered to be masterclasses in how to craft a mobster film, with the main difference being that Goodfellas is based on a real-life story. The film chronicles the rise and eventual fall of mobster Henry Hill and his associates.
Pull me in, they start giving me all kinds of questions, you know, this and that. He says, so what are you going to tell us, tough guy? I said, my usual, zero, nothing. I tell you.
Among Hill's friends is Tommy DeVito, a borderline psychopathic gangster who's prone to bouts of extreme violence. Pesci plays the character of Tommy masterfully, earning an Academy Award for Best Supporting Actor for the role. The real-life Henry Hill also commended Pesci's acting, saying that he matched the real Tommy 99% of the time. Goodfellas was a massive hit with critics and audiences, and is widely regarded as one of the greatest films ever made. Currently, Goodfellas holds an impressive score of 8.7 on IMDb.com, indicating a massive approval by fans.
You miss it this distance.
Well, you got a problem with what I did, Anthony?
Oh, no. Hey, no.
Fucking rat anyways, whole family's all rats.
Do you agree with our list? Be sure to comment below. Also, don't forget to subscribe to our channel and be the first to receive new top 10 videos from Stream TV.